So we have here that x is equal to a times 10 to the power n, and we're asked to find x squared. So in other words, we're going to do a times 10 to the power n squared. Now that's just the same as doing a squared multiplied by 10 to the power n squared. So we can just square those two individually, and that comes out as a squared multiplied by, and now using the laws of indices, we're going to multiply those two together, so we get times 10 to the power, multiply n by 2, and you get 2n. So the question now says, in standard form, and this is the problem, we've got to make sure that this number is in standard form. Now we are told that a, that number a, because we need to know the size of a, remember, for this to be in standard form, this number here must be somewhere between 1 and 10. Now if we look at what it tells us about a, it tells us that a is greater than or equal to the square root of 10, but less than 10. We want to find out what a squared is though, so if I just square each part of that inequality, so we've got a in the middle here, sorry, a squared it now becomes, the 10 is going to become 10 squared, in other words 100, and the square root of 10, if we square that, it comes out as 10. Now that's no good because we're looking for a number which is between 10, which, sorry, between 1 and 10, and actually we can see that a squared is between 10 and 100. I can see though that if I divide a squared by 10, a squared over 10, in other words I'm dividing all of this by 10, then that's just going to come out as a squared over 10 is greater than or equal to 1, but less than or equal to 10. And that's what I'm looking for. I'm looking for this number to be somewhere between 1 and 10. Now, if I have multiplied the left-hand number here, sorry, if I've divided the left-hand number here by 10, then to keep everything the right size, what I'm going to have to do is multiply. So I've divided by 10 on this side, which means I'm going to have to multiply this one by 10. Now, multiplying a power of 10 by 10, so for example, if you've got 1,000 and you multiply it by 10, so remember 1,000 is 10 cubed, if I multiply that by 10 to get 10,000, then that's the same as 10 to the power of 4. In other words, the power goes up by 1. We add 1 to the power. So what we did have here was 10 to the power 2n. If I now multiply by 10, that power that was 2n goes up by 1 and becomes times 10 to the power 2n plus 1. In other words, our standard form answer is just a squared over 10 times 10 to the power 2n plus 1. And that's my answer in standard form.